Lesson 54, The Character of Christian Service. In today's lesson, we shall learn about the character of Christian service. We shall see that though there are hardships and rejection, there is greater reward and joy. We shall see how the Lord provides for His servants, and that mistreating them brings judgment. While there is great honor for the Lord's servants, who are privileged to know and serve Christ, proud religious people cannot find eternal life. We shall also learn that our service for the Lord should not hinder our worship of the Lord. In this chapter, we find Jesus sending out His workers to preach. But this time, it is not just the 12 apostles, but 70 of His disciples. He sends them out in pairs to visit the various towns and villages. He asks them to pray for more workers, because there is much work to be done and not enough workers. In the great work of reaching souls, there is always plenty of work to be done. If more Christians are committed to sharing the gospel message, then the kingdom of God will expand all the more. Jesus again tells His disciples to take no extra money, shoes, or bag with them, and to enjoy whatever food is set before them in the house that welcomes them. He was teaching them that the worker is worthy of his wages. As they faithfully served God and preached about the kingdom of God, then they should be glad to receive whatever kindness people provide for their care. These servants were to represent God Himself, and thus, if they were well received, then God's blessing would be upon the house that accepted them and heard them. Those who rejected Christ's disciples were rejecting Christ and His Father. As they shook off the dust from their feet, they testified of God's displeasure and judgment. The reason the judgment would come so severely upon these towns and villages was because they had seen the mighty miracles done by Jesus or by the hand of His apostles, and this divine witness should have led them to repentance. Jesus said if the same privileges had been given to the cities of the past, such as Sodom, Tyre, and Sidon, that they would have repented. All these former cities were judged by God for their wickedness, and those living in Jesus' time were far guiltier for rejecting the Son of God, who came with a message of mercy and miracles to validate His ministry. In serving Christ, His disciples would experience many struggles and rejection, but one day they would be greatly rewarded for their faithful service. There was great honor in serving the Lord for those privileged to see Jesus and His miracles. Even the great prophets of the Old Testament had longed to know and see the Messiah and His ministry, but they were not privileged to live during the time Jesus would come into the world. Not only was it a great honor for these to serve Christ, but it is also a great honor for us today to serve the Lord Jesus Christ. To those who represent Him to the world, He promises great reward and joy. While the 70 disciples were rejoicing about the spirits being subject to them and the power they were able to use in Christ's name, Jesus said that they should rather rejoice that their names were written in heaven. It is far greater to be a child bound for heaven than to have miraculous power or be someone great in this world. God is pleased to reveal Himself to the simple and sincere, while the proud and wise are not able, with their knowledge and religious effort, to know God. There is such a wonderful privilege in serving the Lord. While many other religious people are trying to earn their way to heaven, and yet cannot attain to eternal life. When a lawyer comes to Jesus asking how he might gain eternal life, Jesus points him to the Scriptures. The man understood that the Scriptures taught it was man's responsibility to love God and to love his neighbor. Jesus said that this is what the man should do, and he would live. Jesus said this not because the man was capable, but to test the man's sincerity. In fact, none of us is capable to fulfill the requirements of God's law and love God and man perfectly. This is illustrated in the story of the Good Samaritan, where some religious men pass by a man in desperate need of help, but a Samaritan man is willing to offer as much help as the man needed. The story should have cut into the lawyer's heart, helping him to see that all his religious effort will never make him fit for heaven. Those who are truly God's children are not so because of their religious efforts, but through faith in Jesus. They have been born again and now have the nature of God living within them, so that they act as God would act. When someone possesses God's free gift of eternal life, they are so grateful to be saved, and the Spirit of God living within them fills their heart full of God's love and goodness. This will manifest itself by loving God and loving our neighbors. All the religion in the world cannot change a heart or make someone a child of God. Only those who humbly, sincerely accept Jesus by faith have eternal life. Serving the Lord is a very good thing, and every Christian should find a place where they can serve God. While serving is good, it is not better than worship, and should not take away from the importance of devotion or worship. Martha was concerned and upset that her sister Mary was not busy serving as she was doing, and Jesus had to tell Martha that her service would not be permitted to take away the good part that Mary had chosen, which was sitting by the Lord to learn from him. Nevertheless, do not rejoice in this, that the spirits are subject to you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven. Luke chapter 10, verse 20.